science is the best tool ever devised for understanding how the world works.
Science is a very human form of knowledge. We are always at the brink of the node.
Science is a collaborative enterprise spanning the generations. We remember those who prepared the way, seeing through them also.
If you're scientifically literate, the world looks very different to you, and that understanding empowers you.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
We can do science, and with it, we can improve our lives.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
The story of humans is a story of ideas that shine light into dark corners.
Scientists love mysteries. They love not knowing.
I don't feel frightened
by not knowing things.
I think it's much more interesting.
There's a larger universal reality of which we are all a part.
The further we probe into the universe, the more remarkable are the discoveries we make.
The quest for the truth in and of itself is a story that's filled with insights.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
We can do science, and with it, we can improve our lives.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
The story of humans is a story of ideas that shine light into dark corners.
From our lonely point in the cosmos, we have, through the power of thought, been able to peer back to a brief moment after the beginning of the universe.
I think that science changes the way your mind works, to think a little more deeply about things.
Science replaces private prejudice with publicly verifiable evidence.
There's real poetry in the real world. Science is the poetry of reality.
We can do science, and with it, we can improve our lives.
From my heart and from my hand, why don't people understand my intention?
Understand my intentions. Ooh.
R is for red, O is for orange, Y is for yellow, and G is for green. B is for blue, I for indigo, and B is for violet. And that spells Roy G. Biv. Roy G. Biv is a colorful man, and he proudly stands at the rainbow's end.
So you'll see.
Roy G. Biv is a colorful man, and his name
so
spells out
see.
The whole color spectrum. Roy G. Biv is a colorful
so
man,
see.
And he proudly stands at the rainbow's end.
So you'll see.
Roy G. Biv is a colorful man. The whole color spectrum.
You'll never see a unicorn, but you'll see a rainbow. And inside every rainbow is the spectrum of light. You'll never see Roy G. Biv, but he's inside the rainbow. 'Cause inside every rainbow
O is for orange, Y is for yellow, and G is for green. B is for blue, I for indigo, and V is for violet. And that spells Roy G. Biv. Roy G. Biv is a colorful
so
man, and he proudly stands at the rainbow's end.
So you'll see.
Roy G. Biv is a colorful man, and his name
so
spells out
see.
The whole color spectrum.
Understand the world around us, know the cosmos with less doubt. To comprehend there is something instead of nothingness throughout. Oh, oh. If we don't make sense of it all, ask the why that matters most. Oh, you should turn our focus inward. Smallest things that we can know. For centuries, great thinkers pondered how this world could be comprised. Is there an underlying constant to the world before our eyes? The ancient Greeks composed a particle so infinitely small. And they called these constructs atoms, the smallest things of all. From the structure of the atom, all the elements are known. And from elements come molecules, as chemistry has shown. First a nucleus sits densely in the center of a sphere, and its core is protons bound to neutrons. The atom's mass is mainly here. About the nucleus buzz particles that are vastly smaller still. Electrons with their minus charge, in their orbitals they spin at large. From the structure of the atom, all the elements are known. And from elements come molecules, as chemistry has shown. Sense of it all,
understand
the world, ask the why that matters most.
Know the cosmos with this doubt.
We should turn our focus inward
to comprehend there is something
to the smallest things that we can know.
To the smallest things that we can know.
Centuries, great thinkers pondered how this world could be comprised. Is there an underlying constant to the world before our eyes? From the structure of the atom, all the elements are known. And from elements come molecules, as chemistry has shown.
Have you ever pondered the movement of a star? Planet or a galaxy up in the night sky? Have you ever wondered why the sound of a siren is constantly changing as it passes you by? It's good to have many questions about the world that you face. That's how all of humankind's discoveries are made. Siren, light of that star, both are ever changing. It depends on where you are in relation to the source of sound or light alike. The frequency that you receive very well might cause sound to become lower in pitch or light to redshift. This change in observed frequency found by Doppler, the physicist.
just as the sounds of sirens change as they come and go. The light from other galaxies helps us come to know. The universe is vast in size, growing all the time. As shown by redshifty light, it's come to meet our eyes.
It's good to have many questions about the world that you face. That's how all of humankind's discoveries are made. It's good to have many questions about the world that you face. That's how all of humankind's discoveries are made.
With me.
Science is real. From the Big Bang to DNA. Science is real. From evolution to the Milky Way. I like those stories about angels, unicorns, and elves. Now I like those stories as much as anybody else. But when I'm seeking knowledge, either simple or abstract, the factor with science, the factor with science.
Science is real, science is real, science is real.
Science is real, from anatomy to geology. With science, the truth is with science.